Hello and welcome to a Minecraft explaining video. My name is Mr. Coolwijk and I am your geography teacher for today. And today we will talk about climates. And to talk about climates, we first need to know the difference between climates and weather. And after we know this difference, we can go over all the climates. And for that, we will use the climate system of Köppen. And of course, our loyal friend Franz is not gonna miss out on this. Isn't that right, Franz? So, lean back, relax, and most of all, learn something new. The weather, as you can see, is quite unpredictable and very, very spontaneous sometimes. So, the weather is the condition of the atmosphere at a certain time at a specific place. So what I mean with this is that the weather, that the condition of the atmosphere, so the air above us, is different at every certain time at every specific place. So now, right now at this time, at this specific place, it is raining. But at the same time, maybe a bit further that way, it might not be raining. So the weather is very local. It can even happen at home that while you're walking your dog, at one moment it's raining and at the other moment it's dry. And then when you get home, it's raining again. But if weather is the condition of the atmosphere at a certain time at a specific place, then what is climate? Well, this here. So climate is the average weather measured over a period of 30 years. So, of course, the weather might mean that one day it's snowing in the Netherlands and then the other day it's not. Doesn't mean that we live in a polar or in a cold climate. The climate is the average weather measured over a period of 30 years. So the big difference between weather and climate is that weather is very locally at a very specific time, and climate is the average weather over a very long time, namely 30 years. All right, now that we know the difference between weather and climate, it is time to look up for the different climate systems. All right, Franz, are you ready? Yeah. But Franz, before we begin, we need to get something straight. We work with the Köppen Climate System. The idea of the Köppen Climate System is that it consists of five letters, and each letter indicates a certain climate. And these letters are A, B, C, D, and E. It is very important to know that after these big letters, some of them have small letters. The A, the C, and the D all can have a small letter behind it. The B and the E have other big letters behind it. These small letters tell you something about how much it rains, or we call it how much precipitation there is. So we have the small letter of S, which means dry summer. You also have the letter W, which indicates a dry winter. So as you see, the letter indicates when the period is dry. And you have the letter F, which means, fuck man, it's raining all year. There is no dry period. But remember, once again, you can only put those three letters behind A, C, and D. Behind B and E, you will put other big letters, but we will go over them. So let's start here, in our very first place. Where are we right now? Franz. Franz is gone. What? Don't be mean. Come on, I'm trying to explain something and you're hiding. It's very, very rude of you. Anyway, we are here, in the A climate. The big letter A as the first one. The big letter A stands for a tropical climate. As you can see, there is a small f behind it. which means, as we know, no dry period. So this means it's a tropical climate and it rains almost all year round. But when can you say that something is a tropical climate? So the tropical climate means that the lowest temperature of the year is 18 degrees Celsius or higher. So, in the tropical climate where I am right now, the average temperature will not be lower than 18 degrees Celsius. And in this case, it should be a no dry period. So actually, let's do it like this. It should look something like this. Yeah, Frans, I know, that is very not nice. So this is a tropical climate, which is rainy all year long. And that's what makes this a tropical rainforest. So an AF climate is always a tropical rainforest. All right, Frans, let's go. We are going on an adventure. All right, buddy. It's you and me. Let's go. Have arrived. All right, now we have left the tropical rainforest behind us, as you can see, and we traveled a bit further away. Now we are in an AS climate. So again, we have a climate, which is tropical, but this time it is a small s. So it means that there is a dry summer. So there's a dry summer, and it doesn't rain all year around. And because it doesn't rain all year, there is not enough water for a tropical rainforest to grow. Oh no! You interrupt my explanation by hurting yourself. You silly dog. Oh, come on, Frans. I will give you meat. I know it's not vegetarian. You are not vegetarian. Here you go. Come, come. Come, come. Come. There you go. Yes, good job. So, where was I? Oh yeah. A is tropical. S means it's a dry summer, which causes for less water to be here and therefore less tropical rainforest. And oops. And therefore this will turn into a savanna climate. Of course, it is still an A climate, indicating that it is 18 degrees or warmer in the coldest month. So the savanna climate is always 18 degrees or warmer, but has a dry summer, therefore having a more savanna-like look with the trees and some grasses and everything. A perfect example of weather. Look at this. Here it is dry and here it is raining, very locally at a specific time at a specific moment. I told that A, C, and D can have small letters, but B and E have big letters. So let's go over them. After the savanna, you arrive at much drier locations, and these are indicated with the B letter. B climates stand for dry climates. So B equals dry climates. The B climate means that there is less than 50 millimeters of precipitation, which is rain, per year. So in every B climate, there is less than 50 millimeters of precipitation over a whole year. But In this case, you have a big B and a big S. The S stands for steppe climate. And with the steppe climate, the precipitation happens over the entire year. Meaning that even though it is very dry, less than 50 millimeters, it still falls over the whole year. So every month or so, or a little bit, there's a little bit of rain, creating this steppe-like area or steppe-like climate with a bit of grasses, some a bit drier than the others, but still enough rain for some grasses to grow. Now, if we go to the other B climate, which you can usually find after the steppe climate, you come to the BW climate. Again, B is dry climate, indicating that there is less than 50 millimeter of precipitation in a year. But the BW stands for desert climate. And the big difference between the steppe climate and the desert climate is that the desert climate has a long dry period. Meaning that unlike in the steppe, the rainfall happens gradually over the whole year. In the desert, it is usually dry for a very long time, and then at some point it rains a little bit and then it is dry again. And that is why in the desert you can find barely any plants, maybe some cacti or some dead plants. So the B climate is always dry, but depending on if the rain falls throughout the whole year or in one moment and the rest of the year it is dry, it is a BS or a BW with big letters. Now, Franz, let us travel to the temperate climate. Ah, the perfect weather condition for a temperate maritime climate. This reminds me a bit of home. Oh, okay, that's a bit scary. So here we are. Oh, whoa, 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 calm down, calm down. Oh no, I miss Franz. Franz, where are you? Alright, that's much better. Here we are, in the temperate maritime climate. And as you maybe remember, the sea climate can have small letters behind it. But what does the sea climate mean? The sea climate is a maritime climate. And maritime is another word for sea, the ocean. This climate is much like our climate, or the climate you can find in France or in Italy or in Germany, and in large parts of Europe. There are some rules to this climate. So on average, the lowest temperature, of the year lies between -3 and 17 degrees Celsius. That's quite a long and difficult sentence, but it will make sense after we get to the continental climate. But the sea climate indicates basically that in the coldest month, on average, the temperature is between -3 and 17. Because if the coldest month was higher than 18, it would have been an A climate. And if it's lower than -3, it is another climate. Now, of course, you can have CS and CF and CW, meaning that, for example, in CS, it is a maritime climate with a dry summer. Or, for example, CF, it's a maritime climate with no dry period. Or even CW is then a maritime climate with a dry winter. So depending on when it is dry or when it's not dry, you get CS, CW, or CF. But the rule is the sea climate is a sea climate because the coldest month is between -3 and 17 degrees Celsius. And you get something like this, a landscape that looks quite familiar for us. Nice forests with trees and green luscious fields with flowers and bees. So happy. Now, of course, the maritime climate is always close to the ocean, as maritime indicates that there is an ocean close by. The other climate that we're going to go to now is the D climate, which is a continental climate. So D is continental climate. Now, it is very much like the sea climate, only a bit more extreme. But when is something a D or a continental climate? Well, something is a continental climate when the lowest temperature of the year is -4 degrees Celsius or lower. So now you understand why the maritime climate is from -3 till 17, because it is a continental climate when it is -4 and lower. But not only does the lowest temperature of the year needs to be -4 or lower, the maximum temperature of the year is 11 degrees or higher. So a continental climate means that on average the lowest temperature is always lower than -4, and that the maximum temperature of the year is always higher than 11. So in the summer it needs to be higher than 11 degrees Celsius, so warmer, and in the winter it needs to be colder than -4. By this you can already tell that during the winter the continental climates are very cold with lots of snow, and during summer it must also be quite warm. So the differences are very big between the coldest and the warmest month. Here you can also find, for example, big fields with trees and different kinds of trees. And you can find that mainly within the Central Europe, or if you go to more away from the ocean. All right. Now for our final destinations, we shall use the Hyperloop. So I hope you are ready to start your engines and lift off. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for flying with Mr. Coolwijk Airlines. I hope you had a pleasant trip. We have arrived at our final destination, and that is the letter E. The letter E stands for a polar climate. Now, there are different types of polar climates, and as you know, only the letter B and E have big letters behind them, meaning something else than the small S, W, and F letters. We start with the ET. ET stands for a tundra climate. So ET is tundra climate. As you can see, it is quite, cold there. There's some snow, and also there is no trees growing or any other plants. And that's because it's too cold. Because during winter, it is lower than 0 degrees Celsius. And during summer, it is between 1 and 10 degrees Celsius. So during summer, it is actually warm enough for some of the snow and ice to melt, but it is just not warm enough for any plants or other things to grow. Maybe some grasses or some moss, but that's about it. That's the ET, or the tundra climate. Usually you can find the ET climate close to the poles, the North and the South Pole. But on the actual North and South Pole, you have the EF climate. And EF climate is the eternal snow climate. The only rule for this is that all year it is below 0 degrees Celsius. Basically, on average, it is never warmer than 0 degrees. Ooh, polar bears. Look at them being all cute. I just want to say that I'm sorry for global warming. Yes. And finally, we have the EH climate. EH stands for High Mountain Range Climate. As the name suggests, you can find this climate on high mountain ranges. Here I have found a not so high mountain range, but the idea is that even on other high mountain ranges you can find the EH climate. One rule for that is that, of course, it is usually on high altitude, so somewhere high into the mountains, and of course the whole year it is lower than 0 degrees Celsius. Basically the same as the eternal snow climate, except the EH, or the high mountain range climate, you can find on mountains. So if you go skiing in the Alps, for example, in France, you can also find an EH climate. Or maybe if you go climb the Mount Everest, on top there's always snow. And that is because it is basically an eternal snow climate, but on top of the big mountains. Thank you guys for watching this awesome explaining video about the climate system of Köppen. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you learned something new. And of course, I will see you guys next week in another new, splenty, awesome, super duper new explainer video with me, Mr. Coolwijk. Yes, goodbye!